So APN Property Group, who are we? So we're a specialist Asia Pacific real estate investment manager. So real estate is all that we do, and we've been investing in real estate for over 20 years. So our investment philosophy in property is one that is based on property as an investment for an income stream. So we believe in property for income. We like the predictability and the stability of the income stream that you get out of investment in property. So three things today that I want you to take away. So number one, why you should not ignore the world's fastest growing commercial property market. So here's a quick overview of the APN Asian REIT Fund. We invest, so the fund holds Asian REITs, and the REITs invest in institutional investment grade commercial property in key Asian markets like Hong Kong, Singapore, Tokyo, etc. So in line with APN's property for income investment philosophy, the fund is very much an income-focused fund. We pay monthly distributions, and currently the fund's yield is sitting at about 6.1%. So since inception, which was nearly 7 years ago, we've returned about 14.02% per annum, and so about half of that is from income. So diversification is we think, a very key feature of the fund. So by diversification, I mean not just the fact that, you know, the underlying property exists across the key Asian markets, like I mentioned before, but also across key property types. You think of property, like residential property, but within the REIT structure, there's commercial we focus on commercial property, and by commercial property, there are property subtypes like the industrial space, the office buildings, retail shopping centres. But within the Asian market, we also have a few more different, more interesting subsectors like multifamily, which doesn't yet exist in Australia, senior housing, data centres. So this is a big picture, you know, why we think Asia is a compelling place to be, and why Asian commercial property we're very excited about. So we think this map is pretty paints a very good picture. The more people living inside the circle than outside of it. So it's the sheer force of numbers, people, the demographic change, but also the fact that these people are moving up to join the middle class. And that's got big implications for the demand for real estate. As you have people moving up to the middle class, there's more demand for housing, there's more demand for office space, there's more demand for, you know, retail centres and the like. So this is a picture of this growth in the middle class that's driving the economic growth within the Asian region. So out of the next billion people to enter the world's middle class, 87% of that is coming from Asia. So Asia, as a share of global GDP, we know that's increasing, and that's increasing at a pretty good clip. So if you go back to 1990, I think Asia's share of global GDP was something like 25%. If you move forward to 2050, that's going to be more like 50%. So that's a pretty big shift. And similarly within the Asian REIT market, so this is the pie chart shows Asian REITs within Asia Pacific. So back in 2001, Australia had a pretty established REIT market. The Asian REITs were just starting out. We were a pretty small slice of the pie. But fast forward to 2018, that's completely, you know, reversed. Asian REITs are now, you know, 2/3 of the Asia Pacific pie and a growing piece. So, and this doesn't take into account of the fact that the Indian REIT market and the Chinese REIT market has yet to get going. So there are a lot of other countries in Asia that have yet to finalise REIT legislation, and we think when that happens, this Asian REITs as a percentage or as a piece of the global REIT pie is going to become far more significant, and we're very excited about this growth. So this is the APN Asian REIT Fund, and where are we invested? So about just under 40% of the fund is invested, so that's a look through to where the physical properties are located, just under 40% in Japan, and that's very much weighted towards Tokyo, just under a third in Singapore, Hong Kong, China, making up about 20%. And the bar chart here represents what we believe is a good measure of, or a good representation of the quality of assets. So if you look at the red bars, they represent the Asian markets. So Hong Kong is actually the world's most expensive office market, followed closely by London West End, and then you've got Tokyo and Singapore. So Hong Kong, Tokyo, and Singapore being the key markets that we invest in, you know, we think the real estate that exists within these markets are extremely valuable and of very high quality. So this is a more, I guess, concrete example and one that, you know, hopefully resonates with some of you. This is a comparison of Vivo City. For those of you who've been to Singapore, it's a big mall, a very big mall in Singapore. And you compare that with Westfield Sydney, just down the road. So Mapletree Commercial REIT owns Vivo City, and we own Mapletree Commercial REIT within the Asian REIT Fund. And Westfield Sydney is owned by an Australian REIT Centre Group. So Vivo City is a bit smaller in size, about 40% smaller. But if you look at the shopper traffic numbers, Vivo City gets 10 million more visitors a year. They generate roughly an equal amount of sales at about $1 billion. And that actually means on a productivity basis, Vivo City is actually a lot more productive than Westfield Sydney. And that's got implications for rents and value. So this we see as a real representation of the quality of these assets that we invest in. I'll touch quickly on governance, because that's a question that we get quite frequently. You know, what's the governance like in the Asian REIT sector? So because Asian REITs were developed a little bit later versus the US REIT market, which has been around for well over 50 years, and the Australian REIT market for over 30 years. What the Asian REITs have done is taken best practice from these markets. So they've put in place things like restrictions on gearing and limitations on development activity, and that's a pretty key difference if you compare the Asian REIT market and the Australian REIT market, which some of you might be familiar with. So for example, Singapore REITs have a limit, a 45% limit on gearing. We think that imposes very good discipline in terms of gearing levels, and we saw how that sort of unwound in Australia in the GFC. And another key difference is the limitations on development activity. So the Australian REITs, they incorporate a lot of development earnings within their income streams, whereas in Asia, that's actually limited to about 10%, and in markets like Japan, they're actually prohibited. So what that means is these REITs that we invest in are more plain vanilla, asset-owning, income-generating vehicles with very little volatility in their earnings and their income stream and what they pay out in the form of dividends to us as investors. So we like that stability of the income stream that these Asian REITs generate for us. So second thing today, diversification, the key diversification benefits of Asian listed real estate. So a quick comparison here, Asia versus Australia, for those of you again who might know the local Australian REIT market well. Australia's got 31 REITs within the index. The Asian REIT sector has got about 180. And what's a more telling figure here, I think, is the fact that because it's a much bigger universe, the market cap concentration outside of the top 10 names is 14% in Australia, but 70% in Asia. So that means we've got a far more diversified group of names in our universe. So let's talk quickly about correlations, because that's important for, you know, why we think it's a good diversification play. So this is Asian REITs correlation with other asset classes, like global equities and Australian equities. So anything below 0.4 means that it's a very low correlation. So Asian REITs versus global equities and Australian equities are actually very lowly correlated. And what's not on here is the correlation between the Australian REIT market and Australian equity. So if you hold Australian REITs, it's actually a 0.7 correlation with the Australian equity market. So we feel that Asian REITs are a very good diversification play in a portfolio because of this correlation. So low volatility versus other asset classes. So the APN Asian REIT Fund is in the red, and the next bar up is our benchmark. So we managed to fund to get lower than our benchmark volatility, and we've been doing that very successfully. So if you compare, I guess, the Asian REIT market versus the other REIT markets, you get the Australian REITs on the far side at 12.3%. And you think, okay, well, of course it's going to be, you know, lower volatility because it's a more diverse basket. But if you compare the Asian REIT market versus the global universe, well, the global REIT market is also a diversified bucket. And the reason is because of that governance that I mentioned before. So Asian REITs benefit from the fact that, you know, there's strict rules around how much income they've got to pay out, the level of gearing that they're not allowed to exceed, and also the amount of corporate earnings that they generate or actually don't generate compared to, you know, markets like the US or the Australian REIT market, where some names have a big proportion of their income that they pay out to investors being generated by development profit. And that's obviously much more volatile than, you know, an income stream coming out of owning an office building, for example. So we like the fact that it's much lower volatility versus, you know, the global REITs and also the Australian REITs. So our track record of income and growth, we're pretty proud of. So this is a chart that I think is can be quite surprising to some. The Asian REITs versus the Australian REIT market and also versus Australian equities. So over the long term, you know, we get on the risk scale, which is at the bottom, we're much lower volatility, as I mentioned before, versus the index, versus the Australian REIT market, versus Australian equities. And we think that, you know, it's a very, very low volatile, high income, relative high income way to invest in Asia. So I'll end on this slide. Income REITs as a source of Asian REITs, the source of income and also diversification. So the fund pays a monthly distribution, currently at 6.1%. It's paid monthly. The performance has been very strong. We're ahead of the index over all time periods, and the fund's been going for nearly 7 years. It's a income, a way to get access to the growth markets within Asia, the key gateway cities in Asia, Singapore, Hong Kong, and Japan. And also it's a diversified strategy, you know, the 180 REITs that exist within our universe. And that brings with it, you know, stability, the fact that we invest only in a structure that is very well governed by the regulations that I mentioned before, gives us comfort in the fact that the income that we receive from the REITs is stable and predictable. Thank you.